Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Medical Hub. If you like my video, then please subscribe my channel and share with your friends. So now let's start. In this video I am going to share some multiple choice questions with answers of AIIMS nursing officer exam. These questions are very important that will come in AIIMS nursing officer exam or staff nurse exams. So please watch it carefully. In this video there are 30 MCQs with answers. In my last video I had given 40 MCQ with answers. So now let's start. Question number 41. The first indicator of protein energy malnutrition or PEM in children is, there are 4 options. A. Overweight for age. B. Weak and lethargic child. C. Underweight for age. And D. Child having less intake of food. Right answer is C, underweight for age. So the first indicator of PEM or protein energy malnutrition in children is underweight for age. Next question, question number 42. Mr. Ram has just returned from the post anesthetic care unit PSU from a hemorrhoidectomy. His post operative order includes sitz baths every morning. The nurse understands that sitz bath is used for. Option A, promote healing. B, relieve tension. C, lower body temperature. And D, cause swelling. Right answer is A, promote healing. So the nurse has to understand sitz bath is used for promote healing. Next question, question number 43. The most common method of reproduction of bacteria is, option A, binary fission. B, sexual. C, budding. And D, spore formation. Right answer is A, binary fission. So the most common method of reproduction of bacteria is binary fission. Next question, question number 44. In following, which is a side effect of streptomycin? Option A, 8th cranial nerve damage. B, damage to growing cartilage. C, bone marrow depression. And D, diarrhea. Right answer is A, 8th cranial nerve damage. So the side effect of streptomycin is 8th cranial nerve damage. Next question, question number 45. A child with acute leukemia is started on chemotherapy including prednisone. A side effect of prednisone that may be exhibited is, option A, alopecia. B, mood changes. C, anorexia. And D, weight loss. Right answer is B, mood changes. Next question, question number 46. To control bleeding in a child with hemophilia, a nurse would expect to give, option A, albumin. B, fresh frozen plasma. C, factor 8th concentrate. D, factor 2nd, factor 7, 9 and 10 complex. Right answer is B, fresh frozen plasma. Next question, question number 47. A pediatric nurse educator provide a teaching session to the nursing staff regarding hemophilia. Which of the following information regarding this disorder would the nurse plan to include in the discussion? Option A, hemophilia is a Y-linked hereditary disorder. B, male inherit hemophilia from their fathers. C, female inherit hemophilia from their mothers. D, hemophilia a result from deficiency of factor 8. Right answer is D, hemophilia a results from deficiency of factor 8. Next question, question number 48. Which of the following finding is the best indication that fluid replacement for the client with hypovolemic shock is adequate? Option A, urine output greater than 30 ml per hour. B, diastolic blood pressure greater than 90 mm of Hg. C, respiratory rate 21 breath per minute. D, systolic BP greater than 110 mm of Hg. Right answer is A, urine output greater than 30 ml per hour. So the best finding is the best indication that fluid replacement for the client with hypovolemic shock is adequate is urine output greater than 30 ml per hour. Next question, question number 49. The clinical manifestation of a nurse should expect in a patient with acute lymphocytic leukemia are option A, petechiae and alopecia, B, anemia insomnia, C, anemia petechiae, D, alopecia and bleeding gums. Right answer is C, anemia and petechiae. So the clinical manifestation of a nurse should expect in a patient with acute lymphocytic leukemia are anemia and petechiae. Next question, question number 50. Which of the following is most important to prevent the progress of disease in thromboangitis oblitans or Buerger's disease? Option A, controlling BP, B, controlling diabetes, C, weight reduction and D, smoke cessation. Right answer is D, smoke cessation. Next question, question 51. Which medication will be ordered for a client with pulmonary embolism? Option A, warfarin, B, streptokinase, C, acyclovir and D, heparin. Right answer is D, heparin. Next question, question number 52. The client with deep venous thrombosis or DVT is at highest risk to develop. Option A, pulmonary embolism, B, pneumothorax, C, pulmonary edema and D, pneumonia. Right answer is A, pulmonary embolism. So the client with DVT or deep venous thrombosis is at high risk to develop of pulmonary embolism. Next question, question number 53. Hypoparathyroidism is characterized by option A, high serum calcium, B, low serum calcium, C, high serum potassium and D, low serum potassium. Right answer is B, low serum calcium. Hypoparathyroidism is characterized by low serum calcium. Next question, question number 54. A 3-month-old infant has been diagnosed with congenital hypothyroidism. What is the probable effect on the child's future if treatment is not begun in early infancy? Option A, lifelong myxedema, B, more severe mental retardation, C, development of spastic paralysis, D, repeated episodes of thyrotoxicosis. Right answer is B, more severe mental retardation. So, is the probable effect on the child's future if treatment is not begun in early infancy is more severe mental retardation. Next question, question number 55. What is the priority nursing care to a client with severe hyperthyroidism? Option A, assist for recent emotional trauma. B, provide calm, non-stimulating environment. C, provide diversional activity. D, encourage range of motion exercise. Right answer is B, provide calm, non-stimulating environment. Next question, question number 56. Which one of the following does not act a neurotransmitter? Option A, cortisone, B, epinephrine, C, acetylcholine, D, norepinephrine. Right answer is A, cortisone. Cortisone does not act as a neurotransmitter. Next question, question number 57. What should be included in the nursing care plan for a client with diabetes insipidus? Option A, blood pressure every hour, B, strict intake and output, C, urine for ketone bodies, D, glucose monitoring 4 times a day. Right answer is B, strict intake and output. Next question, question 58. Which of the following cannot be corrected by dialysis? Option A, hypernatremia, B, hyperkalemia, C, decreased hemoglobin, D, elevated creatinine. Right answer is D, decreased hemoglobin. Decreased hemoglobin cannot be corrected by dialysis. Next question, question number 59. During diuretic phase of acute renal failure, the client must be assessed for signs of developing. Option A, hypovolemia, B, metabolic acidosis, C, renal failure and D, hyperkalemia. Right answer is A, hypovolemia. So, during diuretic phase of acute renal failure, the client must be assessed for signs of developing hypovolemia. Next question, question number 60. A, sky oxalate enema is ordered for a client who has acute renal failure. What is the primary purpose of the sky oxalate enema? Option A, to remove fluid from extracellular space. B, to exchange sodium ions for potassium ion for sodium ions. To reduce abdominal pressure. D, to introduce potassium into the bowel. Right answer is B, to exchange potassium ion for sodium ions. Next question, question number 61. A client is admitted with the diagnosis of BPH or benign prostate hypertrophy or hyperplasia. Which symptoms is least likely to be present in the client? Option A, urinary frequency. B, pus in the urine. C, dribbling. D, decreased force or urine stream. Right answer is B, pus in the urine. Pus in the urine is the least likely to be present in the client with diagnosis of BPH. Next question, question number 62. Inability to speak or understand the spoken words is called as option A, insomnia, B, aphasia, C, apraxia and D, agnosia. Right answer is B, aphasia. Inability to speak or understand the spoken words is called as aphasia. Next question, question number 63. A 2-year-old child is admitted to a burn unit with partial and full thickness burn over 35% of the body. After admission assessment and review of the physician order, the priority nursing interventions focus on option A, sedation with morphine sulfate, B, inserting a Foley catheter, C, inserting nasogastric tube, D, restricting IV fluids. Right answer is B, inserting a Foley catheter. So the priority nursing interventions focus on inserting a Foley catheter. Next question, question number 64. In caring for a client after cataract surgery, nurse should notify physician if the client has option A, blurred vision, B, eye pain, C, glare and D, itching. Right answer is B, eye pain. Next question, question 65. Which of the following condition is an early symptom commonly seen in myasthenia gravis? Option A, dysphagia, B, ptosis, C, fatigue improving at the end of the day, D, respiratory distress. Right answer is B, ptosis. Ptosis is a symptom that's seen in early in a myasthenia gravis. Next question, question number 66. An assessment specific to safe administration of IV mannitol is option A, vital sign 4 hourly, B, waiting daily, C, urine output hourly, D, level of consciousness 4 hourly. Right answer is C, urine output hourly. An assessment specific to safe administration of IV mannitol is urine output hourly. Next question, question number 67. A client is admitted with a C6 spinal injury. The client most likely has which condition? Option A, aphasia, B, hemiparesis, C, quadriplegia and D, paraplegia. Right answer is D, paraplegia. Next question, question number 68. Which of the following is a characteristic of a patient with advanced Parkinson's disease? Option A, disturbed vision, B, forgetfulness, C, tremors and D, muscle atrophy. Right answer is C, tremors. Next question, question number 69. When caring for a child with meningococcal meningitis, the nurse should observe for option A, identifying purpuric skin rashes, B, low grade mature of the fever, C, palatal paralysis and glossitis, D, continual tremors of the extremities. Right answer is identifying purpuric skin rashes. Next question, question number 70. Which of the priority nursing assessment in the first 24 hours after admission of client with thrombotic CVA? ऑप्शन ए प्यूपल साइज एंड प्यूपिलरी रिस्पॉन्स, बी कोलेस्ट्रॉल लेवल, सी इकोकार्डियोग्राम, डी वाउल साउंड्स। राइट आंसर इज ए प्यूपल साइज एंड प्यूपिलरी रिस्पॉन्स।